Hello, good evening students. We have already derived some important parameters of the underground cable. Today we have to discuss dielectric stress of the underground cable. So it is well known fact, under operating condition of the cable, the insulation is subjected to electrostatic forces. This is known as dielectric stress. The dielectric stress at any point in the cable is in fact potential gradient. It is also known as potential gradient. So it is also referred as electric intensity at that point. Consider a single core cable with core diameter or conductor diameter capital D and internal sheath diameter of capital D as shown in figure. Electric intensity at any point x meter from the center of cable. So in previous section we have considered one more radius above the d centimeter below the capital D, that is thickness of insulation region. We have to consider one more circle of the radius at x distance from the center. So at that radius, so electric intensity at a point x meter from the center of cable is given by x equal to q divided by 2 phi absolute permittivity relative permittivity x volts per meter. So by definition, electric intensity is equal to potential gradient. Therefore, potential gradient g at a point x meter from the center of the cable is given by ex equal to g. Therefore g equal to same expression we shall repeat, g equal to q divided by 2 pi absolute permittivity relative permittivity x volts per meter. Give the equation number 1. Let V be the potential difference between conductor and sheath. So it is given by V equal to Q divided by 2 phi absolute permittivity relative permittivity log E capital D by small d volts. From this expression it is possible to frame the expression for Q. Q equal to, you arrange equation number 2. So next step is substituting the value of Q from equation 2 in equation 1. So we are getting G equal to finally capital V divided by X log of E capital D by D volts per meter, that is expression 3. So this gives potential gradient at a distance x from center of the cable. So it is clear that from equation 3 the potential gradient varies inversely with distance x. Hence we can say that potential gradient is maximum when x is minimum. When x is minimum, this will occur at the core or conductor diameter is D, that is the minimum, and vice versa, the surface of the conductor. On the other hand, the potential gradient will minimum at x is maximum. X is maximum, it is the at point of sheath surface, that is x equal to capital D by 2. Getting the idea? Hence substitute simply x equal to respective values for small d by 2 and capital D by 2. So, number 1, maximum potential gradient is given by when x equal to d by 2. Substitute this value in equation 3. So, we are going to get g maximum, that is maximum potential gradient, equal to 2v divided by d log e capital D by small d volts per meter. That is development of equation number 4. Next, minimum potential gradient. Minimum potential gradient, when it occurs, x equal to capital D by 2. Hence, substitute x equal to capital D by 2 in equation 3. So, g minimum equal to 2v divided by d log e capital D by d volts per meter. Obtain the expression 5. Then you observe, make the ratio of maximum potential gradient to minimum potential gradient, g max by g minimum. Substitute values from equations 4 and 5. Finally, we are going to get g max by g minimum ratio equal to capital D by small d. That is expression number 6. The variation of stress in dielectric is also as shown in figure. It is clearly observed that dielectric stress is maximum at the conductor surface and its value goes on decreasing as we move towards the sheath, from conductor to sheath. At the conductor point, maximum gradient, the gradient goes on decreases towards the sheath diameter. It is observed g maximum to g minimum in figure number earlier. So, it is very important that knowing of maximum stress is more useful in designing of cables. For example, if a cable to be operated such a voltage that minimum stress is 5 kilovolts per millimeter, then insulation used in the cable should have dielectric strength at least minimum 5 kV per minimum, 5 kV per millimeter, or more than this value. It gives the operating condition of that voltage and respective stress. Sir, related problems, some simple problems. A 33 kV single core cable has a conductor diameter of 1 cm and a sheath of inside diameter is 4 cm. Find the maximum and minimum stress in the insulation. Already we are knowing the maximum gradient and minimum gradient expressions, simple relations. Write down one side given data. Voltage is given 33 kV. Conductor diameter small d, it is given 1 cm. Internal sheath diameter capital D, it is given 4 cm. Hence, maximum stress or gradient equal to 2V divided by small d log E into capital D by small d. It is our standard value. So, you substitute the value and keep voltage in kilovolts only. Keep voltage in kilovolts only, small d and capital D, that is centimeters only. So, answer what we are getting? Kilovolts per centimeter, 47.61 kilovolts per centimeter. Similarly, you solve for g minimum. G minimum equal to 2V capital D log E capital D by small d. You substitute the value, then finally we are going to get 11.9 kV per centimeter. Either you can use that ratio also. After finding one value, जी मैक्सिमम बाय जी मिनिमम इक्वल टू कैपिटल डी डिवाइड बाय स्मॉल डी, दैट आल्सो वर्कआउट. वन मोर प्रॉब्लम, द मैक्सिमम एंड मिनिमम स्ट्रेसेस इन द डाइलेक्ट्रिक ऑफ ए सिंगल कोर केबल आर 40 किलोवोल्ट्स पर सेंटीमीटर एंड 10 किलोवोल्ट्स पर सेंटीमीटर रिस्पेक्टिवली. इफ द कंडक्टर डायमीटर इज 2 सेंटीमीटर, फाइंड द थिकनेस ऑफ इंसुलेशन एंड ऑपरेटिंग वोल्टेज. सर, राइट डाउन द गिवन डाटाज. जी मैक्सिमम इज गिवन, मैक्सिमम पोटेंशियल ग्रेडियंट 40 केवी पर सेंटीमीटर रिस्पेक्टिवली. मिनिमम ग्रेडियंट गिवन 10 केवी पर सेंटीमीटर एंड कंडक्टर डायमीटर इज गिवन 2 सेंटीमीटर. इंटरनल शीथ डायमीटर इज नॉट गिवन, वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट. सो वी हैव टू यूटिलाइज द रेशियो. जी मैक्सिमम बाय जी मिनिमम इक्वल टू कैपिटल डी बाय स्मॉल डी. Then you go for capital D equal to, substitute the values, you are going to get as 8 centimeter. The thickness of insulation, you clearly observe from the diagram, already you got. The thickness of insulation is above the radius of conductor up to radius of sheath. That is D by 2, small d by 2 to capital D by 2, hence capital D minus small d divided by 2, that is the thickness of insulation. Divided by 2 means radius. Radius, it is shows radius. Getting the idea? Above the conductor up to sheath diameter is the thickness of insulation. This value becomes 3 centimeter. Then to find the operating voltage, you can utilize G maximum or G minimum expression. Now I am using G maximum equal to 2 volt V divided by D log E capital D by small d. You substitute all the values. See there V equal to 55.45 kV. So one more problem, a single phase core cable for use on 11 kV 50 Hz system has conductor area of 0.645 cm square, it is area centimeter square, and internal diameter sheath is 2.18 cm. The permittivity of dielectric used in the cable is 3.5, that is relative permittivity. Find maximum electrostatic stress in the cable. Number 2, minimum electrostatic stress in the cable. Number 3, capacitance of the cable. Number 4, charging current. It is one of the good example. So instead of giving diameter of conductor, it is given area of conductor, cross sectional area of conductor. A equal to 0.645 centimeter square. Then you find by using the relation diameter of conductor D equal to under square root of 4a divided by pi. So we are going to get around 0.9 centimeter. That is the diameter of conductor. Internal sheath diameter is given, capital D equal to 2.18 centimeter. Then by knowing the both diameter values, go for maximum potential gradient. G max equal to 2V divided by D log of E capital D by small d. Substitute L1 kV, that only L1 in kilovolts. So G max we are getting 27.65 kilovolts per centimeter. Small d and capital D, you substitute same units, centimeter, centimeter. Similar fashion, go for minimum potential gradient. you can utilize G minimum. Either you can use ratio G maximum by G minimum. So you are getting around 11.5 kilowatts per centimeter. Then third one, capacitance of the cable. Already we are knowing the standard expression. Relative permittivity into length 41.4 log base 10 capital D by small d into 10 to the power of minus 9 farad. So you substitute all the values. L, it is in meters. Capital D, small d, those are in centimeters, into 10 to the power of minus 9, 0.22 into 10 to the power of minus 6 farads. Once you are knowing the capacitance value, then you can go for XC, capacitive reactance. Capacitive reactance equal to 1 divided by 2πfc. Hence, you go for charging current. Charging current IC equal to V by XC. Here, voltage you substitute in volts. While calculating the current, you substitute voltage in 11,000 volts. C, that is farads. F is frequency. So, we are going to get 0.76 ampere. Sir, you work out problems and understand the electrostatic stresses, because in next class, I am going to discuss with capacitance grading. Thank you to one and all.